How's it going, everyone? JT Judgment here, and welcome back to another FIFA 15 Legend review. Today we're going to be taking a look at one of my favourite legends and players in general in FIFA 14 Ultimate Team last year. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Portuguese left winger, Paulo Futre. Now, like I just mentioned, he did turn out to be one of my favourite players in FIFA 14. So, guys, I was really, really, really excited to use him in FIFA 15 and just to see how well he would play this year. And my God, he was absolutely fantastic. And I'm just going to say right off the bat, he is one of the best, if not the best legend I have used so far. The boy is just insane. Now, let me go through some of the pick of the bunch of his in-game stats, guys, just to give you an idea what he does have. He's got 88 acceleration, 94 on the agility, 91 balance, 91 ball control, 94 dribbling, 94 penalties. Absolutely fantastic. And when you consider that he is an 87 rated legend, which is one of the lower rated ones, his stats are pretty decent, guys. Card fist stats are pretty awesome as well. He's got 92 dribbling, 84 pace, 80 shooting, 79 passing. Those are the stats mainly you guys are going to be looking at. Let me go through his positives and negatives now, guys, giving you an idea on how he plays and if he's worth the coins, basically. Now, let me go through his minuses, because there are not that many, guys. The minuses that I found is that his aerial ability really isn't the best. I mean, he's not the tallest of players and his physical stat isn't the greatest, so you shouldn't really expect him to be winning anything in the air. At least he didn't for me, so that was not exactly a major minus, but it's something to, you know, keep in mind if you're somebody that likes to have left wingers that are decent in the air. His strength wasn't the best either. He was muscled off the ball very, very easily to players and defenses that managed to catch him and pull on his shirt and actually, you know, try and take the ball off him. So his strength was a big downside for me. One of the biggest downsides that I found with him as well is that his passing was very inconsistent. I do believe he made a couple of assists for me, but he was the sort of player where I could go into one game and his passing would be fantastic. I could go into the very next game and his passing would be absolutely dreadful. You know, all I had to do was just tap the Y button or the A button to just, you know, lay off the player right in front of me perfectly, and he would hit it so damn hard that it would just give the ball away straight away. It was really, really weird and very frustrating how inconsistent it was. Pretty much everything else that I found with this card was a plus. I mean, his pace is fantastic. You will see from the goals, guys, his pace plays a major part in the goals that I did score with him. In my opinion, it feels it's in the late 80s. It's 84 on the card, but I got to say, he feels like it's, you know, 87, 88, if not 89. He was very, very fast, and defenses that I came up against had a hard time catching him. His finishing inside the box and long shots are absolutely insane. Again, the goals are doing all the talking, guys. These are the sort of goals that he will score with ease every single game for you. If you know what you're doing with long shots and if you know what you're doing with dribbling in this game, then this guy is going to suit your style of play perfectly. Like I said, finishing inside the box and long shots, I had absolutely no problems with. His weak foot is fantastic. He's got 5-star weak foot, which is going to be the main selling point to a lot of people, because a lot of people out there I know have to have 5-star weak foot on their attackers, and if you're using this guy as a winger or a forward, then, you know, he's going to be perfect with either foot, shooting from any distance basically. He scored some absolutely fantastic goals for me with his right foot. He is left-footed, guys, so using him on the left wing, you can use, you know, whatever foot to score your goals. I had no problems there. What else is there? Dribbling and ball control. I don't know why I haven't mentioned this already. 92 on the card. It feels a lot better, in my opinion. You know, I haven't used the players that have more than that. You know, the obvious one being Messi. I have not used Messi yet. But his dribbling and ball control is so good that I can only imagine that it should feel more than 92. You know? It was just absolutely insane. Again, you will see from the goals, guys, just dribbling in and out of players through teams with ease. It is unbelievable. And his positioning was fantastic for me as well. Now, I used him as a left forward in the 4-3-2-1 formation. I had no problems with his positioning, and I had no problems with him not making the runs. He was always making the runs that I needed him to make when I needed him to make them the most. And he was always in the left wing, left forward position, ready to, you know, receive the pass and score the goals that I needed him to score, you know? So his positioning is fine. He's also got the perfect work rates if you do decide to use him as a forward or a winger, guys. High attacking, low defending. Now, is he worth it, guys? I gotta say, yes. Definitely, he is one of the best, if not the best legend, guys, that I have used so far in FIFA 15 Ultimate Team. I had an absolute blast using him. As of making this review, guys, he does go for around about the 400,000 coin mark. It is definitely worth it, guys. And with player prices going down as they are right now, by the time you see this video, his price may have already drastically dropped from what I got him for. So I've got to say he is definitely worth 400k. In my opinion, the way he plays on the pitch and the quality that he performed for me, I would say he is worth a million coins. That's how well he performed for me. Stop right now, guys. Go out and buy yourself Paulo Futre. The boy is absolutely insane. And that's going to wrap up this Paulo Futre review, guys. If you did enjoy this video, and as always, if it did help you decide whether or not to buy him, then as always, a like is greatly appreciated. It really, really does help the channel, guys. Also, subscribe now for more legend reviews to come in the future. And as always from me, please take care, and I will see you all next time. Ta-da, guys.